Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the beautiful Weinberg Theater and the 29th Annual Elementary Honors Chorus Concert. My name is Susan Thomas, and it is my great privilege to serve as the curriculum specialist for elementary visual and performing arts for Frederick County Public Schools. And on behalf of the Curriculum and Instruction Department, Frederick County Schools, and the Music Department, we welcome all of you and thank you so much for your continued support of the arts in our elementary schools. What you're about to see tonight is one of the crown jewels of our performance year, where the best of the best, the cream of the crop, pick the cliche that you want, but we all come together for 2 days here in this beautiful theater under the direction of a professional conductor to share with you the gift of music tonight. There are lots of folks that we need to thank tonight, mostly, maybe not mostly, but certainly all of you out here, the parents, grandparents, uncles, neighbors, carpools, taxi drivers, you know, whatever, pick your role, but you make a commitment too to supporting the arts and to getting your students to rehearsals and to instill in them the love of music and the commitment of being in an ensemble as special as this. So we all certainly thank all of our families and friends for their continued support of the arts program here in Frederick County Elementary Schools. Thank you. All of the efforts and all of the work that our teachers do are just a part of what happens to put together this incredible night of music. I have just one person that I would like to thank, and she'll talk a little bit about some other special people that are here tonight, but I'd like to pass the microphone over to our coordinator of our Honors Chorus program, and without her tireless dedication and probably more hours of work than I'll ever know, none of this would be possible. So it's my great pleasure to introduce to you Mrs. Jocelyn Barker, our coordinator for Honors Chorus.
Thank you, Mrs. Thomas. As she said, good evening. My name is Jocelyn Barker, and I am tonight's event coordinator. I would like to welcome you, as she said, to the 29th annual Frederick County Elementary Honors Chorus. It's such a great honor that we've been able to have this program in our schools for 29 years, hopefully 29 more. Your children represent the finest fifth grade singers in FCPS. They were selected by an audition process, and each school is only allowed to send 5% of their fifth grade students. So you will be glad to be enjoying a performance by a truly gifted group of children. Before the chorus comes in, I would like to take a moment to offer a special thanks to some very special people who without them tonight would not be possible. First, I'd like to take the opportunity to thank the Weinberg Center for the use of their beautiful facility and for their patience and tolerance in allowing us to fill it with 150 fifth graders for 2 solid days. The ticket booth people, they really got quite a show when we were doing solo auditions. A big shout out to Jonathan Cook, our traffic and safety coordinator. He's always creating new and even more efficient ways to keep our children safe and comfortable during their time here. I'd like to thank Natalia St. Jean and Kim Woods, whose beautiful voices you've probably been hearing on our children's CDs. They are the voices and they practiced for quite a while to record them for our children. I'd like to thank Amy Devers and Ed Bauer, who are our accompanists for tonight. They've also put in a great deal of time. A big shout out and thank you to Eric and Gary from Duet with Music, who graciously continue to help provide materials for our concert. They donated quite a few pieces of music for tonight's show. And as Mrs. Thomas said, thank you to you, the families, the loved ones, and of these remarkable children whose continued support for elementary music makes tonight possible. And finally, I couldn't do this without all of you, thank you to the Frederick County Public School elementary music teachers who rehearsed with these children. They did it before school, after school, during recess and lunch. And you're who convey the love of music to children every single day. So if there are any music teachers out there in the audience, most of them are sitting up front, if you could just stand and be recognized. And without further ado, you will meet your your conductor shortly. Her name is Mrs. Judy DeBose. You can read all about her on the back of the program. She has been working so wonderfully with these children these past 2 days, and she is a fantastic, fantastic person to work with. She is going to be conducting our group this evening. Thank you very much, and enjoy the show.
In their heads, music no one else has ever heard. Sometimes they hear it by a composer, but they hear it in a new way. When they share their version of the music by others, they are called arrangers or editors. Without these musicians, our choice of songs would be limited. For most of us, our contact is with performers. We may think the performers also wrote the songs they sing. It's often difficult to find out who wrote the songs we hear. In our concert, we will tell you a little about the composers.
Our first song is Colonel Bogey's Grand Old Flag. It combines two songs in one rousing patriotic march. It credits two composers and an arranger. It is the arranger who brings the two songs together. Colonel Bogey March was composed by Kenneth J. Alford in 1881 in London, England. Alford was the British Army Bannister, F.J. Ricketts. A few weeks before the start of World War I, Ricketts was stationed in northeast Scotland. This is where he composed his most famous march, Colonel Bogey, while playing golf.
Your Grand Old Flag was composed by George M. Cohan, a musician born in 1878, who wrote, composed, produced, and appeared in more than 36 Broadway musicals and published more than 300 songs during his lifetime. Cohan wrote You're a Grand Old Flag in 1906 for his stage musical, George Washington Jr., and was the first sheet song from a musical to sell over 1 million copies of sheet music.
J. Jacqueline Kennedy, the widow of President John F. Kennedy, requested that American composer and conductor Leonard Bernstein compose an extravagant theatrical production for the grand opening of the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C. Mass by Leonard Bernstein premiered on September 8, 1971. The piece communicated the confusion of the early 1970s, questioning authority and advocating for peace. In this scene, a group of boys rush up to the celebrant with bongo drums and sing a joyful Gloria Tibi. The word means glory to you.
Our soloists for this selection are Marcella Barbosa, Brooke Aitken, Claire Smith, Audrey Kilgore, and Sophia Brusco.
Performed in the classic ABA form, composed by George Friedrich Handel, who was born in 1685, for the opera Rodelinda, first performed at the King's Theatre in the Haymarket in London on February 13, 1725. The words express the power of music to improve one's state of mind. Are you troubled? Music will calm you. Are you weary? Rest will come to you. Music, the source of all gladness, heals your sadness. Handel became famous there and is most remembered for composing the oratorio Messiah, which includes the famed Hallelujah chorus.
Are thou troubled? Music
Catch a Falling Star was made famous by the singer and entertainer Perry Como in a version released in 1957. Paul Vance and Lee Pockris wrote the song that became the first single to receive a gold record certification. With this single singer, Como won the 1959 Grammy Award for the Best Vocal Performance by a Male. The songwriters Vance and Pockris were responsible for writing hundreds of songs of the 1950s and 60s, but the one you may know is called the Itsy Bitsy Teeny Weeny Yellow Polka Dot Bikini. Catch a Falling Star encourages us to have an optimistic outlook with a pocket full of starlight to cheer us in difficult times.
Caan folk song from the northern part of the Philippines. A folk song is not credited to a single songwriter. It is often derived from street cries, chants, and idle thoughts, which join together to form a melody. Listen to the sound of the village waking for the day, followed by a peaceful chant, like the sounds coming from the rice fields at sunrise. But as the village awakens, the tranquility is replaced by new sounds, birds and animal calls, and the festive yells of children playing. Weary from a day of activity, serenity finally returns at sunset. The words we sing mean, come, come let us enjoy singing. As one community, it is good that you came to us. Every day we work.
Oh!
often, songwriters compose the lyrics of songs to comment on the conditions facing the world community. The events of 1989 inspired American musician and teacher Andrea Klaus to compose Song for a Russian Child, a ballad to the children in Russia. Her song raised sensitivity and awareness and pointed out that a Russian child has the same hopes and needs as children living here in America or anywhere else in the world.
This has been a really wonderful 2 days. I've enjoyed this so much. It's wonderful to be able to do this in your own community with children who are your neighbors. And in fact, some of you are my neighbors, aren't you? Yeah. John Rutter, an English composer, said, "A church or a school without a choir is like a body without a soul." For the past 2 days, I challenged these young people to process complex series of instructions using higher-order thinking skills. I'm sure there's a principal out there who will be happy to hear that. To produce this concert, some embraced the challenge with eager enthusiasm. Some found it frustrating, but as you can see, they all came through to present this performance. I was moved by the sense of responsibility evident among these singers. They were responsive when I asked them to try to do something new, like in that one piece, and they were able to maintain a great sense of humor when they were growing tired of a task. I've invited them all to come and sing with me in the Frederick Children's Chorus, and I hope that they accept my invitation. They're wonderful, bright, musical children. I have to say that without the help of all of these great music teachers, nothing like this could ever happen. And it's been a joy working with each of them. Some of them I've known for years, and some of them I met here this week. And I can't thank enough the two people seated at the piano who have, you know, the accompanists are like they're like your guardian angels when you're a conductor. And so if you would help me, please, in thanking them. They are marvelous musicians. It's been an honor to work with these folks this week, and it's a great pleasure to do this right in my own community where I've lived for 40 years. I'm still a transplant, even though I've lived here 40 years, but it feels like the only home I've ever had, and I really want to thank you for this wonderful opportunity, and now I'll let our young speaker announce our final selection.
Our concert will come to a close with Tuimbe, Let There Be Music, and an African-style original composition by American composer David Wagner. In addition to English phrases, the composer incorporates the Swahili text, Tuimbe Tucheze Sote, meaning, let us sing, let us dance all together. Swahili is a Bantu language spoken largely in Kenya and Tanzania. The English text praises the beauty and joy generated through music. It is layered over a rhythmic Swahili text chant, creating a buoyant, multi-textual quality. Let there be music, music that lives inside of me. Let music ring from sea to sea.